Welcome to the SME 2-Minute Drill, where we cover a ThoughtSpot feature in 2 minutes or less. In this video, we're covering TQL Basics. The clock is running, so let's get started. In order to build schemas and load data into worksheets in ThoughtSpot, we need to build out the data architecture behind the scenes. So this is done through the ThoughtSpot query language, or TQL. So TQL is a lot like SQL. For our sales data, you can see that I've created the database and also each of the individual tables that we've used in our data set. So all of the fields have a corresponding data type, and we also have a primary key. We can also assign shard keys if we need to. Down here, we have alter table statements that add constraints to each of our tables, in this case, a foreign key to relate back to a primary key. This is going to create all of the links to our tables to build the schema so that we can eventually join them together. Now, from here, we can run this TQL through the front end, or more popularly, you can run it through the back end. So in this case, when you're back in the shell, you type in TQL to invoke the TQL command line. From here, you could run your create table statements, alter table statements, all of that. If you ever get lost and need to find out how to write TQL or what kind of data types you can choose, you can go to the ThoughtSpot TQL reference in the guides, and this will give you all of the different TQL statements in order to view schemas and data, create different schemas, all of that. So there's a lot of information on here, and I'm sure that you'll be able to find it either here or in the ThoughtSpot community. If you would like to follow along with our 2-minute drill, you can download this exact data set from our website at the link below. Until next time, this has been an SME 2-minute drill for ThoughtSpot.